So let's pull it hard. So coming to the conclusion, what kind of a person will suit to this kind of a motorcycle, the Hornet 2.0? What's up YouTube, welcome to the review of the Hornet 2.0. So I had an amazing time riding this motorcycle in city and in highways. So not much time, only 3 days, and I have to say that I'm impressed. I saw many things not that great in the spec sheet, but when it comes to the motorcycle, the engine, the character of the engine is way different from what it is written on the spec sheets. So let's look into each and everything of this motorcycle. So yes, this is the new version of the Hornet, which is 184cc, unlike the previous version. So I was just surprised to see why Honda pitched into this 180cc segment than going to a 200cc. Then I was thinking that, okay, Honda doesn't want to make much of a competition in the 150cc segment, neither into the 200cc, so they just safely kept the 184cc there, so that this is more powerful than the 160 or 150cc that you get in the market now, but still not as great as the 200cc that you see, like the RDR 200 or the Duke 200 or the NS 200. So looking on to the engine of this motorcycle, I already mentioned that it's a 184cc, and it's just a brilliant engine, I have to say that, because there is absolutely no vibration when you sit on the motorcycle and turn the ignition on. You don't feel like there is an engine running below your balls, and it is that refined also. And surprisingly, it is very torquey and a bit powerful in the low end as well as the mid ranges. But when it comes to the top end, it's not getting saturated, but it still has got that grunt. I was able to do something like 119-120 km per hour. Even though it's a 5-speed gearbox, which is a pretty decent speed for this kind of a motorcycle. That's what I told. Honda just doesn't want to get into any kind of argument. They just want to place the Hornet just in the middle of the commuter segment, the 150cc and the slightly performance-oriented motorcycle like the 200cc. It's very rough happy. You can rev it to the core, and the engine is not that choppy also, even though it's a 5-speed gearbox. It's definitely torquey and powerful than the 160cc, and it's very light and it's easy to ride. Yeah, of course, the highlight of this motorcycle is the upside down fox coming in, and I have to say that it's a good thing. The front suspension as well as the rear suspension is set to a moderate side. I don't say it is too plushy, neither too hard. It's easy to ride inside city, like in bad roads as well, but it's not giving too much of that wavy suspension feel when you're taking it on highways, especially on high speeds. Let's look into the seat. So the seat is wide and broad. I'll say that the seat is ideal for fluffy butts also, and coming to the billion seat also, it's comfortable, it's wide. One thing I can say is that this is also not too soft nor too hard. You can use it for touring. So I'll be making a different touring review about this motorcycle as a different video, because that covers the different things about the motorcycle. So that's why it's a different video itself. And when you get onto the motorcycle, the handlebar is a bit short, and it feels a bit twisted in the other way, like towards outwards. So you get a nice a little bit of sporty riding stance with your upper body, and this motorcycle doesn't have too much of seat height and all. With my height, I'm pretty much comfortable, and the foot peg is rightly beneath you, so that gives a very nice riding ergonomics. It's really good for city use, because not too much of sportiness, and it doesn't tire you and all. Only one thing is, like, I feel like the handlebar is a bit short, and when we look into the dash, so it's a negative LCD display, and things are pretty much readable on this. So you have a lot of information on this. This is the tachometer, this is speedometer, time, this is odometer, the fuel level indicator, the gear position indicator, and two trip meters, voltage. Yeah, that's all. And when we look around the motorcycle, I mean, at least Honda made sure that this motorcycle comes with all LED lights, be it the headlight or the indicators and all. It's all LEDs, and you can definitely feel premiumness in this motorcycle, be it the paint quality or the plastic quality or the kind of the alloys it has been used. Everything looks premium, everything looks nice. Rest all things we'll see when we go for a ride. So finally I'm back on highway, so let's go for the ride. I had a small feeling that if I'm getting a bit more raised handlebar, I'll be more comfortable to tour on this motorcycle, like long distance touring. But certainly a good handlebar, because you have a lot of control on the motorcycle, and especially this motorcycle is not that heavy. I have to say that it's very light, so it's much easy to ride, be it in the city or on the highway. So let's pull it a little hard. Oh, it's in the second gear. That's the thing, man. I always feel like it's in the first gear, even though it's in the second gear. But when I whack it open, I get to know that it's second gear. So that's what I told it. Even the second gear is very torquey. So let's pull it hard.
It's powerful. Like hitting the 100 km per mark is like a piece of cake on this motorcycle. It's much comfortable also because it doesn't have any kind of vibration. Even when you turn on the motorcycle, when you are in the parking lot, you have to get to know that the motorcycle is on by hearing the motorcycle, not by the vibrations from the motorcycle. That's what I told. Even though it's a new engine, Honda has made this motorcycle like very refined. I'm truly loving it for the kind of engine refinement this has. And seriously, I would expect Honda to make a motorcycle in the 200 or the 250cc segment, but I feel that Honda doesn't want to fight with other competitors for the 150, 160 or neither with the 200cc. I think that's why they took a segment which is 180cc, which almost every other manufacturers are leaving and moving on. So they wanted to bring in a bit more powerful motorcycle. Yes, definitely Honda has successfully made that, because coming onto the BS6 standards, almost every other motorcycle is becoming a bit lazy, but this one, accepting the fact that it's a new engine, it's powerful. Yeah, I forgot to mention about the gearbox and the clutch. So I have to say that the gearbox is a typical Honda gearbox. That means it's very precise, no false neutrals, very comfortable, and it gives you the confidence that you are shifting each and every gear. So in that sense, I'm pretty confident with the gearbox. And clutch feel is like neither too soft nor too hard, which I didn't expect from a Honda, because generally Honda motorcycles has the lightest of the lightest clutch. This one doesn't have that lightest clutch. It is lighter, that's all. And when it comes to braking, I'll say that this motorcycle has good braking bite. I have to agree with that. But my request to Honda is, if you could bring in a dual channel ABS for this motorcycle, that could have been nice, because at this price point, I would expect a dual channel ABS. That too, it's a powerful motorcycle and people gonna rip it around. So having a dual channel ABS is very good. And you see that I'm in the fifth gear and opening the throttle, the motorcycle is jumping off. So it's not a choppy throttle, but certainly even the tallest gear, the fifth gear, is also giving good power. And the same gear will act like a cruising gear when you are touring. So as I mentioned, I was able to do something like 119 or 120 km per hour on this motorcycle, like as the top speed. So if you are looking for a touring machine, then probably easily able to do 90 to 100 km per hour on an open highway. And even though this motorcycle is like an air-cooled one, I really don't feel too much of a heating issue from this motorcycle. I've ridden this motorcycle like around 20-25 kilometers in dead traffic inside Bangalore, so it wasn't heating that bad at all. Yeah, and coming on to these mirrors, I'm not that happy with these mirrors, because this portion of the mirror is a bit short. A slightly more bigger mirror or a wider mirror will give a better view. So coming to the conclusion, what kind of a person will suit to this kind of a motorcycle, the Hornet 2.0? So I'll say that if you want something to use inside city, which should be a bit more powerful than the other commuter motorcycle, and if you want to ride relaxed, then also this motorcycle is fine. If you are someone who wanted top-notch quality in your motorcycle, be it the build quality or the kind of refinement levels, again, this motorcycle is a very good choice. And when it comes to the touring, then also great choice for a beginner tourer. And when it comes to the off-roading, I'll say that you can take this motorcycle just like any other motorcycle in 150cc for off-roading. Not that great. You cannot expect the performance of an X-Pulse when you take this off-road. Since this is light, you won't be facing much of an issue even when you take it to off-roads. So that's it with this review of the Hornet 2.0. And if you are having any doubts on this motorcycle, do let me know in the comment section. And as always, show some love in the form of likes and comments. See you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.